We should not be individualized through schooling to become a tough motherfucker hitting with the elbows to the others because you gotta compete and you become strong. That's not strength, that is aggression. Years ago, we showed as the first ones in medical history that the autonomic nervous system can deeply be influenced. After 16,134 test subjects of endotoxemia bacteria injected, all became sick, very sick, because it's inflammation causing this bacteria, E. coli bacteria. It's a controlled experiment. And it's to find out if we have a natural way, means of our mind, maybe breath, maybe this, maybe that, in hospitals, in a controlled environment, how to beat inflammation, which is the cause and effect of any disease in the end.
Inflammation.
So they created this endotoxemia model that is injecting a bacteria. And it works for 3 to 6 hours. People become really sick. Fever.
Have you done the injection?
Yes, yes. I've done the injection, and then I was the first one to show a complete different chart than all the 16,000 people. And then they said, but that's because you are the Iceman. You are in a freak of near nature, and you do these crazy extreme things, and that's why you are able where others are not able to do that. And then I said to them, no, what I can do, anybody can do. And then they took me on in the end, and I took 18 people to the mountains, 4 days. I learned them to cope with extreme cold in their shorts. I learned them breathing techniques, and I learned them mindset. Mindset is a neurological muscle inside we have. Yeah, it's not placebo, it's a real muscle, neural activity. When that unites, it's called willpower. And you can really connect with that into any part of the brain. And and with that, into parts thought of inaccessible.
Yeah.
And this is the latest study I've shown in Detroit, Michigan, in the Wayne State University, in brain scans. Cold water is stress. In the end, anything out there, the stress, negative stress coming to us, creating cell biological stress.
So when we create stress on the body, how does that help us kill inflammation or disease or sickness?
The sickness, how? By going from your consciousness, your will. We thought of will is somewhere there. It's not over there, it's right over here, and it's a muscle. And you are able to go with that will. Power is the center in the brain, prefrontal cortex, going into the brain stem. The brain stem is about survival. But because we live every day in a very controlled environment, like the world where we live in with the heat, the cold, sedentary lifestyles, going into the car, we got it all controlled by our thinking, not by our feeling anymore. Not nature is coming to us anymore. Thus, the deeper parts, the old brain, the reptilian brain, the brain stem, and the limbic system, the mammalian brain, the animal, is not being lived anymore. We are not living like zebras and giraffes and know the danger and flee and fight and food. And it's all there. The food is there in the supermarket. You don't need to find it. You don't need to flee, fight, but the dangers are still there. And when the dangers come, like inflammation, causing inflammation, then we don't know how to tap into those deeper parts of the brain because we were thinking all the time. Thus, 25% of our blood flow goes into this thinking brain, and the rest is like on standby. by.
Do you think it's possible?
Surviving.
Yeah. Do you think it's possible for someone to, if they're getting a cold or a flu like symptoms, to, without breathing techniques or without cold therapy, can they just use their mind?
Yes.
To change
exactly
that flu-like sickness? Is that
good
possible?
Part.
Or do they need breathing
you,
and
yes.
cold?
No, they don't need it. This is the, we are different than zebras and giraffes. That is true. And that is because we a part of us is animal, but here comes in the human consciousness, mm-hmm. the human power of the mind. And the seat of that is our brain. And our brain, we have learned only to go into the surface, the thinking, and controlling the world around us. With that, we have no way of accessing into these neurological pathways into the depth of our brain. We didn't exercise that. For that, the cold is great. For that, the breathing is great. But once you have done that, then suddenly these neurological pathways are existent. And you know what? This is what I did in Michigan. Showed as the first one in the world, in brain scans, how to get cold water, a stressor, on the body and make it go away. Just my skin temperature did not go down just by using the mind.
Really?
And that could be a circus act or whatever, you know, it's not that matter. It's about how to deal with stress on your body just by using your mind. And stress on your body could be caused by biological stress, mm-hmm. physical stress, emotional stress, yeah. any stress. But in the end, it is cell biological stress. And we have a possible connection between our will and a part of our brain, which is dealing internally, mm-hmm. just through the mind, using the mind, with stress, with the result of stress.
When you're about to enter into 30 or 40 degrees ice cold water, and what is the thing that you think of 30 seconds before? Obviously, you're doing your breathing techniques and other stuff, but what's the thing you think about when you're getting in and then sitting in there, so that your temperature does not change, or maybe it changes a little bit, but not
yes.
drastically.
No, you know, if you stay for 2 hours in, and the core body temperature, the core is not changing. And even in New York, I was with Dr. Ken Kamler, in after 1 hour, 15 minutes in the up till here with the ice, my core body temperature went down to a point where normally, physically, or physiologically, and by medics are stated, this is here we have no power over our core body temperature anymore. It goes spirally down from here, and you're going to die.
Great hypothermia
Hypothermia, getting into coma, wow. body parts shut down, and then you die. We have no way to get down. And I was dangerously past this level.
You were there.
And yes, I was there. I was at Regis and Kelly.
Wow.
And one of the Serena Williams was there, who just won the US Open. Mm-hmm. And she was there. And I was looking there. So I was not busy with controlling my body. I went dangerously down. And then, where normally you cannot go up anymore, I just used my mind. And
what are you thinking in that crazy?
And now comes 30 seconds before I go in, I just say, shut up, go in, feel, be, connect. And this connection they saw now is the connection with the periaqueductal great hemisphere. And what they say, we now have the compelling evidence of the key components of the autonomous processes in the brain related to mood regulation. Where normally we get into depression or anxiety and fear, trauma, PTSD, psychosis, all those things, it's because we don't have a hold on those key components of those autonomous processes. Autonomous is outside of the will, now it's inside of the will, shown in the brain scan, and that to regulate your mood or the emotion itself. This is what they said. And the professors, you can look it up. And it's all been published, by the way. And I'm waiting for the next study on people with bipolar status, because I think it takes 4 days to get people out of their bipolar state of mind and get them back into the sense of control and have balance within themselves, the way nature meant it to be. Because being bipolar in nature, the mammal, it would not survive. It's bipolar. Right. And there comes life. Yeah, well, fuck you, bipolar. I'm going to eat you. You look like a steak.
Yeah.
So, gone. So we are equipped after millions of years how to deal with all those states of mind to become the best in the moment again and regulate that.
Yeah.
But we lost it through the thinking brain too much. We have indulged too much into the thinking brain. So when we get this now back, then we are able, and there's the importance of your work, my work, to bring people to the awareness that they are in control over their beautiful emotions through their beautiful mind.
Absolutely. When you see someone that comes to you that says, I'm overworked, I'm overstressed, I'm depressed, I have no purpose, I'm constantly in a prison in my mind and I have no way to get out, what would be the path that you would recommend in the next 24 hours for them to start moving towards that balance?
Yes.
If they're overworked, stressed, you know.
First I would do a relax. Do you want coffee? Do you want tea? Bulletproof or non-bulletproof? It doesn't matter. Whatever you feel. What do you feel? Relax the person. Bring it away from the anxiety where he is in.
Yeah.
So we have the tendency, we have the power as humans to share love, to share a deeper feeling. And when one is in anxiety, you say,
Chill out, bro.
Chill out, brother. And really pass it on. And some oxytocin coming. And it's all there. It's nature. So that would be the first one.
Okay.
And then, are you ready for some changes? Yeah, okay. Yes, of course. I'm so tired. Okay. If you're tired, we will increase your energy. We will get you back in the sense of control. You drive your own car. It's your car. It's your wheels, man. And you want to go from A to B and enjoy the view while going. So we will get you there. Okay? Is that right? Just relax. I tell them to relax, because a relaxed body is able to store up oxygen.
So if you're not relaxed, you're not breathing, you're not getting oxygen.
And logically, the biochemistry will be less quality. And if that is going to be chronic, it's a loop, then you're going to be exhausted.
All the time.
All the time. That's the burnout and all those things. Shallow breathing, wrong biochemistry, keeping on going. Put some adrenaline on because you got some deadlines to go. And in the end, there is no lifeline anymore.
Right.
Yeah, so something like that. So I get these people, and within 20 minutes of breathing, deep breathing, we know, and they feel completely restored in their biochemistry. And thus, that's who you are.
Right, right.
And from there, they feel, when the biochemistry is right, energy comes. It's mitochondrial. Mitochondrial, you get aerobic. Yeah, aerobic, what is it? It's oxygen. Uh-huh. Oxygen in your little energy factories, and suddenly you get more ATP. ATP is molecules, is energy. And with the energy, let's work on the transportation system. The blood vessels within your body is at the length 3 times the world. It all has its beautiful little muscles, and it wants to be awakened, so it is able to run the blood flow better through the body, bring the nutrients, oxygens, and the vitamins, the life force itself, into the system, to all cells. You know what happens? The heart rate suddenly goes down. 15 to 30 beats a minute, 24 hours a day. Where's the stress? It's gone. Because in the end, everything is cell biological stress. But people don't know anymore. And with that, they get this sense of control over the simply by breathing and going into the cone.
Yeah.
Sorry that it is so simple. Just do it and it comes along.
And for those that don't know your story.
Then we go into the cold.
Yeah. After you relax.
Like tomorrow I got this Oscar actor, actress, Paltrow.
Gwyneth?
Yeah, Gwyneth. Tomorrow. And within 1.5 hours, I will have her in an ice bath. Very stressful environment. And she's going to feel great.
Wow. When is that?
Tomorrow.
Nice.
12 o'clock, or 1 o'clock.
Very cool. For those that don't know your story, why did you get into the ice and breathing training in the first place? This is from like 2 years old, you're always in the cold, or?
Yes, actually, if you go back, way back, I was born traumatically. I was one of the twins, identical twins.
Wow.
And they never knew there was another one. And I came almost too late. Like blue, purple,
wow,
in the cold of a hole way. That's where I came. And my mother was very religious, like naive, religious, strong, as a woman, very strong. She made this invocation and she told me later, oh God, let this child live, because they were to go to cut her open,
wow,
and to get the baby out. And she was in fear about that. She was being pushed from the recovery room to the operation room. And in the hall, just before entering the rubber doors of the operation room, she just got me out with the words, oh God, let this child live. I will make him a missionary. Here we are, the missionary. So I got a mission, but at that moment I was a piece of nothing.
Right.
Like purple, with that invocation, a mother has power.
Wow.
And naive or not, she can change the world. Wow. There, and she can make it hard, like a tattoo on your soul. And that's what happened.
Wow.
And
when did you start?
I was always different than my identical twin brother.
He's still alive?
Yeah, sure. And he's alive, but he's not able to do what I do.
Why
because
not?
I do what I do, because I had different experiences coming there from. Mate imprinted my soul, imprinted my type, my character. It was there, boom. And always being different than him, but 100% genetically the same.
Mm.
So then they did all the studies on us. And then they saw, yeah, it's a genetically the same, but he is not able to do what he is. Mm. And that's because of the training.
Wow. So if he did the training, would he be able to do it?
Yes. And he's doing it now, right?
Yeah, yeah. Gotcha.
And he's healing a lot of people now.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's happening. And everybody who is doing this is able to pass it on and get the same results we scientifically have achieved.
Amazing.
The autonomic nervous system, endocrine system, the immune system, and the deepest part of the brain are now accessible at will for anybody who does this properly. Mm.
And when did you start getting into this? Was this a teen years or?
I think, you know, this is like a subcurrent within, when I was 12, I was reading on psychology and Buddhism, and I was always a little bit strange looking for things out there.
Right.
And wherever I go to get my hands upon, I was into. And when I was 17, I already read so many books, so many religions, traditions, cultures, esoteric disciplines, yoga, kung fu, karate, anything I could do, you know, I had done. And there I found the cold water.
Really?
In a morning, a Sunday morning, a thin layer on the ice, on the water. And looking around, I just undressed myself, went in, and I knew from the inside, this is it.
Wow.
It connects you. And this is what
you can't think about anything else.
Exactly.
You have to think about that moment.
Oh, yes.
The present.
Yes. But it matched my birth trauma. And this is what I later figured out. I was born in the cold of the hole, almost suffocated. Too long in there, suffocate you. You get less oxygen. So the first thing you do when you go into the cold water is You begin to breathe deep. What do you do when you get born? When you
take a deep breath.
You come with a inhale. You go with a exhale. That's it. So the cold does the same. The cold brings you right there, as like rebirthing. And wow. I felt, you know, beyond or deeper than thinking, you feel, this is it. I felt power. I felt this connection, which I had experienced at my birth. And at that time, I was absolutely not aware of anything. But now I was aware that I had touched on something I was always looking for.
Huh.
And that made me feel.
What were you looking for?
That trauma to get a hold on that what was imprinted inside, and that made me the other day come back
and do it again.
And 4 months later, I was able to stay. And this is not for nobody. This is me for 5 to 7 minutes under the water,
holding a breath,
holding the breath after 25 of these deep breaths. And, because that all worked and it was great, you feel a great stillness while doing it. It's like in the fetus position. So I'm out under the water, just on my own, and nobody around. And I had it always just for my own. The trees were there, no leaves, but yeah. You know, that was my little place. Nobody could see it. And there I always trained, every day, every winter. And at a certain moment, I began to separate the breathing and I brought it home.
Hmm.
And then I saw all the lights and all the chakras and oh, whatever they call in all these books, I saw it. And this time, not because of reading, but because of doing it.
Experiencing it, being in it.
And that, yes. And
didn't you have an experience later in your life with where someone died in your life and you came back?
Oh yes, that my wife in when I was 35, with whom I had 4 children and still have, and I work with them.
Yeah.
You saw just two of them.
They're great.
She jumped from an 8-story down because of mental disorder.
Really.
So severe, I mean, like here, just kissing the kids goodbye first. Love was there, but the terror was also there. And she decided to jump and go. That can be life. That can be terror of life, in life. And a lot of people are suffering in this world. I, at that moment, was earning very little, having 4 children. I was in the mountains at that present moment because making money through mountaineering and being a mountain guide and all. My kids were with the family in Spain, Basque country, and she did that.
Wow.
And that had, of course, such a great impact. It broke not only my heart, I was just shocked. You're shocked. You cannot think about it. You don't know what happened, but you have 4 children. So you take care of the children and you go on, but deeply you are broken. Now there I began very consciously going into the cold water, because at that moment, from there on, I had to deal with my own terror in my mind, my own worries, my own broken heart, and it all influences your thinking brain every day. The cold makes your mind still.
Yeah.
You cannot picnic, you cannot think about your worries or about your mortgage or anything.
You can't breathe, you have to focus.
Yeah. And so you are surviving, and surviving is the same part as the emotion, the deep emotion. So that was the only way to still the influence, the emotion, creating all these bubbles in my head. Yeah. My children made me survive. The cold healed me. And now...
How long did it take until you started to heal?
Oh, that took, I don't know, five to 10 years.
Really? To heal the process? Yeah.
To get it consciously to my mind. I think it took me like a month to get a hold of this anxiety inside, something like that. And then from there, I just kept on doing it, of course. And I loved it as I did it before, but now it had its absolute therapeutic power.
Had a purpose too, yeah.
Now look at this, Lewis. Now we are, this happened in 95.
Wow.
It's 2018. It's like 23 years ago. And now I'm a dropout from school. But now I'm teaching the professors and the doctors in all the world that we have an ability to tap into the deepest part of the brain and solve all the matters related to mental disorders and having no control.
Wow.
And there is no pill, no medicine involved. It's your own awareness, your own power. And then you get into the cold and the breathing. And we skip the breathing and the cold at a certain moment. We get in our innate control by our mind, the way the establishment doesn't like it, but the way we should have to confront ourselves with any stressor happening in the world to take care of our beloveds.
Yeah. Well, the establishment doesn't like it because it's not making them money. If you solve
that is the disease. That is the big disease, the withholding. And I think making money, very nice, great. But I don't want pills. I don't want medicine. I want happiness, strength, and health. If you are happy, how much money do you need? You see? How much cars do you need? How much of this? If you're happy, you're happy. Yeah. So if you are able to regulate your own mood, and we found the compelling evidence of the key components of the autonomous processes in the brain related to emotion itself. I want it out there. I want professors and doctors, prove me wrong, guys, because we got it approved already in the science, but now we are with the establishment. So the establishment is there, it's very nice, you can make bridges and big buildings and all that and shoot people to the moon. Let's begin and start guaranteeing happiness, strength, and health, because it's there. Boom.
Yeah.
There, true. Your work and my work collide positively.
Absolutely, man. It's amazing. Where do you feel the most loved in your life?
I just loved your walk. Love.
The love walk.
I think you're a very lovable person. You're a big bear. I get to meet people like you.
Yeah.
And that's amazing.
Yeah.
And that's very lovable, but also very powerful. Because in the end, love is the greatest power in the universe.
Yeah.
If you are in love with somebody, then you fly.
Fly.
There is no thinking anymore. Nobody can stop you.
Fly.
So that love is the biggest one. And that love you got not only for your woman, you got it also for your children.
Yeah.
You got it for, and we should have it for nature. Because then you don't even need the respect. You love it. You're not gonna damage it.
Yeah.
You see? And we lost that because we lost the connection. Yeah. We are wrongly schooled in the from the beginning off. And so the school, like the school of greatness, it starts in the primordial, in the primary school, the primal. Let's not have them just being taught in history, language, and mathematics.
Teach them love.
Teach them love, composed connection. By scientific endorsed a reality wherein they are able to tap into the immune system, endocrine system, to guarantee happiness, strength, health. Happiness is endorphins and dopamines and all that. The health is the control over the tapping into the immune system in all the levels. We have shown. And the strength is the adrenaline. At your service, like the adrenal axis in your conscious will, that it is all there. Yeah. And with that comes the rest too. We should not be individualized through schooling to become a tough motherfucker, hitting with the elbows to the others because you gotta compete and you become strong. That's not strength, that is aggression.
Yeah.
Strength is where we help each other to become the best of ourselves.
That's true.
And it's all there now.
That's true.
There we are.
What's your greatest fear?
Greatest fear?
For you personally.
Why? Greatest fear, wow.
No one's asked you that one, huh?
Yeah, so. No, but if you're being, it's always a different question. Yeah. It looks like the same, but you know, a fearless state, I can explain it like this. A fearless state of being is a being that is able to go with its conscious will into any part of the brain. What is that? That is the sixth sense. The sixth sense. We have shown the sixth sense, seventh sense, and eighth sense now. Through scientific mechanisms, we are able to detect different neurological networks in the brain related to the body.
Yeah.
It's rooted in the body. It's, of course, commanded by the brain. We call it subconscious. And there you got the sixth sense, the seventh sense, and the eighth sense. What sixth sense is the, I make a shortcut, is the ability at will to enter into any part of our brain. We thought there was only 16% being able to be controlled by our will in our brain. And now we have shown in brain scans in Germany with one of the two best brain scans of the world to create 100% neural activity. Mm. That means we are able to create at will, consciously, 100% neural activity within the brain, and thus suddenly the willpower is able to enter into the right neural active parts of any part of that brain. That means we are able to go past the time-space barrier of our thinking. And that is the sixth sense. The sixth sense knows in the future. Sixth sense knows what happened, all with mathematical precision beyond Einstein, anything. It's going to be the future, I will tell you. There is the fearless state of being because your brain and your body are connected to be able to interact and confront with anything that is going to happen in the future. Fear only exists because we are too much into our time, space, little area, narrowed consciousness. And when it is narrowed consciousness, in the future, things will happen wherein you will have to go to another part of the brain to solve the matter at that moment. Those are the life lessons, but it is too narrowed. So that's why the fear comes in. And the fear says only one thing. Go to me and find out why I'm here. It's a signal. Like pain is a signal. Yeah. Psychologically, fear is there. So that is number six, the sixth sense. And you can feel it as confidence. If you are confident, then that is because you are able to go past the time-space barrier, past the narrowed consciousness. Because that's the narrowed consciousness all about. All this enlightenment shit and all that, so far away, it's right over here, right now.
Yeah.
Feel confident. Number six. Number seven is the immune system, proprioception. Neurological network thought of inaccessible. Now we have shown to make it accessible for people. It's the immune system. So what is the immune system? It's a detection system to get the wrong intruders out, like in a moment, not waiting 5 to 7 days and then the flu comes in and the fever and this, and it needs 5 to 7 days to get into the specific answer and get a molecule on the membrane of the intruder, and then suddenly you have no flu anymore. No, you can do that in 5 minutes.
Wow.
With your will, which was able to go past the time space. So that's number seven. Yeah. We got that. We have shown in science, I'm only bringing things together. And then number eight, I lately showed in brain scans in Detroit, how to tackle top down a stressor out of your body. And that is the power of the mind. And I tell you, I'm just at the beginning.
Right.
Yeah, man.
What is your personal fear, though, for you?
I got a family with six. I'm in fear all day long.
Really?
With a 1.5.
Running around?
He doesn't think. He does. We think. And so he goes so fast out of your sight. So I'm dead. I'm dead.
Yeah. So you're afraid of something happening to your family or?
Oh, yes. Really? Yes. And that makes me very attentive. I'm learning of him right now. Because once again, I'm just at the threshold of the power of our mind.
Yeah.
And to dive deeper and explore more. In the end, it is to guarantee love, composed by happiness, strength, and health, guaranteed to our children, and then getting into the power of the mind. This is the new dimension where I got in. They saw me in Germany activating, not even me, I'm just giving the protocol.
Right.
And then they have these people in brain scans, and they suddenly see that at will make it a disco. All the neural activity everywhere. Creating the right neural biochemical environment for the willpower, which is in the end neural activity, to enter into any part of the brain, which is not possible if we are too much, the way we are schooled is narrowed down, then the 25% less of blood flow goes to the other part. Thus, it is not alive. We make it alive. And suddenly the power of the mind is able to naturally go where it needs to go, into the so-called subconscious submarine. You are a submarine to go in and venture and find out what there is going on in there.
Yeah.
In the end, it's for the soul to be able to flourish and to be. And there is all the power of the love.
Mm. I'm curious, who was more influential in your life growing up, your mom or your dad? And what was the greatest lesson they taught you?
My dad was like a gypsy. A gypsy, free, no rules, no this, no that, let it go, indulging into life. And my mother was very strict.
Really?
Yeah, naive, very Catholic, every Sunday to the... And you have to do it so and so and so and so. And I loved my mother. I think she is my if I have a guru, a teacher, it was her.
Wow.
And now it's my dog.
Your dog?
Yeah, because my mother she's ruling. She is still there and she's great. We love our mothers. And my dog, when I go into the mountains, in freezing temperatures, the Iceman and the go Mount Everest and all that. My dog is three times faster. In the mountains, she is playing around. It's -20, -25 Celsius, which is freezing cold. And she's just playing around.
Wow.
So I'm learning if there is a teacher, it's her. But in the end, it's the cold itself. The cold is my teacher.
What is the greatest lesson the cold has taught you?
The cold is merciless but righteous. So that's it. And it's always there. You can always depend, and always you are able to tap into the depth of yourself by going through the initial reflexes of the cold coming upon you. And then suddenly you get a deep peace and deep power. I think it is a noble force.
Wow. Can we do a 3-minute breathing exercise?
Yeah,
together,
sure.
Where you just work with me, guide me, and tell me what to do. And if someone's watching, and if they only have 3 minutes a day to do some type of breathing exercise or a mindset.
You could do in 4 minutes.
4 minutes, okay.
You got a push-up exercise.
Mm-hmm.
This is what we do. And the push-up exercise vacuums the oxygen out of you. But first we're going to oxygenize, we're going to alkalize the muscle tissue. And thus, when the muscle tissue is alkalized, it is the right chemical environment for the neuroperformance neurotransmitter to keep on going. Just to show it to yourself. Besides of that, you get deeply into the autonomic nervous system within 4 minutes.
Let's do it. Can we try it?
Yes.
Let's do it.
I'm going to ask you to do push-ups.
Okay.
Without air in the lungs.
Without air in the lungs.
Yes.
Yes.
And that is because before we are going to alkalize the blood. And that goes into the muscle tissue and that will create the right chemical environment for the neurotransmitter performance to keep on going. Hey, what's the matter? I'm not breathing, got no air in myself, and I keep on going. What is that? That is the alchemist.
Okay.
That's you. Within 4 minutes, thus, you get so fast in your biochemistry, and you hold your breath, which is consciousness, and thus the consciousness goes into the nervous system, into the depth thought of by science. It's not possible. It's the autonomous nervous system within 4 minutes.
Okay.
I think you have 4 minutes every day. And you know what? You're going to feel great. Great. Nice.
So what do I do first? Do we breathe first? Do we do push-ups first? Do we?
No. You know how many push-ups you normally do. Okay. Keep that. And now that is your baseline.
Okay.
And now we're going to do more push-ups without breathing? Is that possible? Hey, be the alchemist. He's going to show. And you're going to feel. Okay. Relax. Relaxed body is able to store up oxygen. 4 minutes. Huh? 4 minutes.
Do we sit or stand for this? Does it matter?
If you stand, you know, you can go directly into push-up exercise.
Okay.
As you wish. As you feel. Relax. Okay, there you go. Fully in. And let it go. Fully in. Let it go. Pull in. Let it go. Get him up. Pull in. Let it go. Keep on going. Pull in. Let it go. Pull in. Let it go. Pull in. Have one thing in mind. You give the best, you get the best. There we are. Pull it. Lightheadedness, loosen the body, tingling. Whatever you feel, make it stronger. Breathe into it. Okay, 90. 80. We are oxygenizing the body, alkalizing the body. Muscle tissue is becoming alkaline. Going good. 40. Pull it, go. Pull it! Go! Pull it! Go! Get it in! Get it in! Go! 10! 9! 8! There you go! One thing in your mind! Give it all, you get it all! Be a mean machine! You are the alchemist. 4, 3, 2, 1. Here comes the last one. Pull it in. Let it go. Stop. And go. No breathing. Let's go. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, go! 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, no, and the locks. 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Whenever you feel the urge to breathe, you can take him in and keep on going. 35, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, okay, 15, right off.
Oh, man.
Well done. This is the way you get deeply into the autonomic nervous system and re-regulate the adrenal axis. It's all happening because he was not breathing and he became vacuum within. Suddenly, you gotta survive. Well, a thing we never do. And it's good for you. You feel, hey, you tell what you feel. Easy does it. Easy does it. Well done, well done, well done, well done, well done.
Oh man, I wish I didn't do chest this morning, but I did a full like chest this morning.
Oh yeah, 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 sure.
But it feels good, yeah.
Yeah.
I was feeling like tingly and lightheaded during the breathing.
That's good.
Yeah. But then I felt like I had a lot of energy when I was, when I breathed all the way out. When I was pushing, I felt like I had a lot of energy.
That's him. That's him. That's him. Yeah. That's the alkalinity in the muscle tissue. And the performance neurotransmitter acetylcholine is able to go. And normally, when it becomes sore, acetylcholine is not able to go anymore. Right. And this could be altered for football or anything.
Sure. Eh? Do you recommend people do that 4-minute exercise every day?
Yes. Yes.
Where they do push-ups?
Everybody has 4 minutes. No excuse.
Should they do the exercise with push-ups or just the breathing?
With push-ups, a lot better. Because you get the shit out of your system.
Really? Yeah, I'm like sweating. It's like toxifying it, yeah.
And you are, the adrenal axis is on, and that resets the body.
Yeah.
And that means you get into this natural biochemical state.
It's like a high.
Right on. Yes. Nice go.
To recover.
That's logical, but that's of all. Thing is, if they want the we got a free app on the website.
How do they get it?
And that is I don't know.
Wim
my
Hof,
son knows.
WimHof.com or
WimHofMethod.com.
WimHofMethod.com.
And there is a free app. And there you got all the scientific science behind it and about the cold, the way the breathing deeply gets into it, and
video training,
yes,
amazing. You're doing workshops around the world right now too, right? So if people want to do a workshop with you, they can go to WimHofMethod.com.
Like in LA, it's going to happen in November.
Okay.
Yeah, and New York, New Orleans, I thought,
sure.
Things like that, all over the world, Australia, Asia, Europe.
So they can find all the information there.
Yeah.
It's great, man.
Yeah.
What is your mission? What do you want people, what do you want to do?
I want everybody to be happy, strong, and healthy, and that it is there, and that you learn to own your own mind, because it's beautiful.
Yeah.
Then you sense a power, and you become powerful, you become proud, and you are a protector.
Yeah.
And you live in harmony with nature, around you, inside, outside, same thing.
Yeah. When you have control, you're not trying to survive and be a victim of life. You're in control of life and you're able to serve other people around you.
Yes. Yeah. We have our energy doesn't need so much to survive and to be. We got so much more energy. And we naturally give that.
Yeah.
But for that, we first have to know who we are. And for that, we need that control. And for that, we are into the science to show everybody has it.
Who are you?
I'm here, a simple dude changing the world.
If there are 3 words to describe you, what would those 3 words be?
I'm crazy about life. No? but this man is crazy, he's crazy, he's crazy. You know, negatively content. And I say, I'm still crazy. I'm crazy about my life and my wife. So the family and being, who am I? I'm the savior, but you too, and everybody is.
Wow, yeah, it's amazing. Well, there's a couple questions I want to ask you to finalize this. One is called the three truths. I don't remember if I asked you this the last time, but I'll ask you now. Imagine it's the last day of your life many years from now, and you've achieved everything you want. the world is healing, the, you know, people gain their power back, there's
amazing.
Less mental stress and disease, inflammation is leaving people's bodies, they're controlling their minds, everything.
Wonderful.
The work you've done is impacting the world, right? Imagine this happening. Your family is healthy, you've got 20 grandkids, whatever you want, everything you want has happened. Mm. But at some point, you gotta leave.
Yes.
You gotta leave this earth.
Yeah.
And everyone's there and it's a great celebration, but you've got to, everything you've created, you've got to take it with you. So your work, your message, this podcast, it's all got to go with you. Mm. But you get to write down on a piece of paper three things you know to be true about your whole life and the lessons you've learned in your life. So you can leave behind three lessons for the world. Mm. What would you say are those three lessons or three truths that you would share with the world?
Have the courage to go to, through fear.
Mm.
Find out who you really are. And heal as many as you can.
Really?
Yes.
Find out who you are and heal.
The real power of yourself. Find your real power. It's much more than we thought.
Mm-hmm.
Possible. And once again, I'm a dropout from school. I'm teaching professors and doctors all over the world.
Yeah.
I got a holistic view. And the holistic view comes from nature. Nature knows more than we have stated in books.
Sure. Yeah.
And gotten into our minds, narrowing us down. And thus it is able to be corrupted.
Yeah.
The soul cannot be corrupted. That's who we are. That is the power I wish for everybody to find. And then to go like a warrior.
That's it, Barry. Well, I want to acknowledge you, Wim, for the consistent madman on a mission that you are to help heal and transform lives. I think you've found a method that works for you and works for so many people. And your passion and commitment, no matter what you look like or what people say about you, you're just a maniac on a mission to change lives. And I acknowledge you for that. I acknowledge you for your huge heart. We sang some songs last time you were here. That was fun.
Yeah,
on the guitar.
Yeah, yeah.
So I acknowledge you for being a passionate, curious child, even at 59 years old, and never letting your childlike spirit leave you. Because I think a lot of people your age, my age, forget who they are as a child.
Mm-hmm.
And it leaves them.
Mm-hmm.
And you've kept that spirit alive, and it's infectious in a positive way with everyone that follows you. So I appreciate you, man.
That is nice. That's great.
Of course, man. Of course, man. My final question for you is, what's your definition of greatness?
Yeah, just to... I'm astonished now every day. Every day I'm astonished. I got this, my little baby. I said, I got a beautiful wife. I'm changing the world. Every day I feel great. I'm a man on the mission. Any man, any woman on a mission is going to feel great.
Mm. There you go. Wim Hof, my man. Appreciate you.
Yeah.
Thank you, man.
No.
Appreciate it.